Hello viewers, welcome to Arunachal Mirror. This is Hibu Mado. We are currently here at the RK Mission Hospital, Itanagar. As you can see, all the doctors and nurses here to support against rape and murder case of PG trainee doctor at RJ Khar Medical College, Kolkata, and to support nationwide withdrawal of services. This protest has been organized by the Indian Medical Association, Arunachal Pradesh State Branch.
We want justice!
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, all the our people of our state. I am Dr. Gautam Gangkar. I am working as a urologist in Ramakrishna Mission Hospital. So our hospital, Ramakrishna Mission, including all the doctors, all the staffs, nurses. Now today we have come in. Today we have come in support. In support of the heinous rape and the murder of one of our doctors at RJ Khar Hospital, Kolkata. So we have come here in support and showing solidarity with our colleagues in RJ Khar Hospital, and also the call given by the National IMA. So we have all come in support of the cause. So today we have just closed our elective OTs and OPDs for one day, for 24-hour shutdown, which is being held all over India. So we are also have come in support of that. But all our emergencies or any urgencies, all will be taken care of. Emergencies open. So we have come to this kind of resort. And we are not happy that we have to close the medical facilities for our patients, but we have been compelled today to come to this. So as you are all are aware, what happened on that unfateful night of 9th August in Kolkata, where one of the lady doctor was doing her duty, and after doing a 36-hour shift, she goes to take rest in her own hospital, in her own seminar hall, and next day it is found that she has been brutally murdered and raped in the same campus. So that has really shocked every one of us, all the doctors, all the medical fraternity also, and also all the people of the whole nation. And upon that, when our doctor colleagues protest for a speedy justice and for a speedy trial, then again, our doctors, our brothers in RJ Khar Hospital, they have to face a brutality from hooligans. They are not allowed to protest. They are protesting. They have all panels, everything is broken. The whole hospital is broken. So that has again utterly shocked all of us, all the medical fraternity here. We all are very much disheartened by all this action. So because of that, the National IMA has called upon all the doctors, and all doctors are united in the cause that we want justice for our late Abhaya. And also we have certain demands from the authorities, from the government, so which I will be elaborating here. First, our demand is that there should be an unbiased inquiry, faster trial, and the culprits should be given a highest punishment of the highest order for such a heinous crime, inhuman crime. That is the one thing. And second thing is that we, as a doctor, as a medical fraternity, we are very hurt that when we are giving service to the people, our service is not being recognized. Rather, what we get from them is such brutality. So we are totally disheartened by this. When you have to understand that when a female doctor cannot is not safe in her own working place, then how is any doctor can give service to the patients? She is a daughter, she is a sister, she might be, it can happen to anyone. How can then in the future anyone can send their daughters to become doctors? They cannot send their daughters to just get all this brutality, to get raped, to get murdered in the same hospital. So it brings a lot of questions about the working atmosphere for the doctors, and especially for the women. It tells a lot of their deficiencies in the women's safety and safety for the doctors. You have to understand that medical profession is one of the most challenging profession in the world. And according to the research, you can see that India comes only next to China in crimes or facing violence. 85% of the doctors in China, they have faced such kind of violence or threat from the patients and patient parties. In India, it's 75%. So it is only, India is only comes second. So you have to understand that as a doctor also, as a nurse also, as a staff also, it's very difficult to work in such situations. And it is a very stressful profession. The highest suicide rate in any profession in India is among the medical professions. You have to understand that nobody wants to come and do suicide. Everybody joins this medical profession just to serve the society, to give their best. But because of so much stress, such things happen. And because of that, we also want that there should be a safer zone for the working of our doctors. There are safe zones, especially for the airport. There are safe zones. There are triple layer of security is there. For any violence against the air hostess or any crew members, there are strict laws are there. Then why they can't give us to the doctors? All hospitals should be declared as a safe zone. If we are not safe, we cannot work. We are here to serve the patients. But thing is, if you are not given safety, nobody will be confident to work. So that is our second demand. And also, our demand is that we also want a central law, a strict law, which should enable the protection of the doctors. Not only doctors, all the medical staffs, all the nurses, and all the medical, so that they can give their best. Nobody can work in the atmosphere of fear. So we want a very strong central law for the support of our medical profession. So these are the basically few demands. And we today, for these demands, we have come here, all the staffs from the RK Mission, all the doctors, and even our administration has also been supportive. So our demand is that all these demands should be taken care of. And most importantly, our justice for this Avia should be given. And we will always be in support. We'll fight till the end. We are in complete solidarity with our brothers in RG Corps Hospital.
Sir, देखने को मिल रहा है आप लोग यहाँ में protest कर रहे हैं, but दो तीन patient लोग आके चला गया है, उन लोगों को पता नहीं था कि आप लोग protest कर रहे हैं, तो उन लोगों के लिए क्या appeal रहेगा या फिर message रहेगा?
वैसे हम लोगों ने जो है social media के through भी और जितने भी news channels हैं सबको भी हमने already inform कर दिया है beforehand also, so that our patients don't suffer. Only we have closed the elective OPDs and elective OTs. Indoor patients jo hai unko sab treatment chal raha hai. We are taking the rounds also, and the emergency is also open. So any patient jinko bhi kuch bhi emergency hai, the emergency is always open. Any kind of problem is there, will be taken care of.
Jaise ki aap logo ka ek banner hai, no justice no duty, to हम लोग क्या एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं क्या ये प्रोटेस्ट और भी बिल्कुल अवस्थे बात होती है 46 में बढ़ेगा
उनके? हम लोग तो ये नहीं चाहेंगे कि ये प्रोटेस्ट आगे बढ़े. हम लोग चाहेंगे कि जल्दी जल्दी कुछ सोल्यूशन आ जाए. हम भी नहीं चाहते कि हमारे कोई पेशेंट सफ़र करे. बट एक एनवायरमेंट हमें भी चाहिए कि वेयर वी कैन वर्क सेफली, और हमारे जो जस्टिस मिले वो ये है. हमारा आगे और प्रोटेस्ट करने का ये नहीं है, बट आगे कैसे सिचुएशन आता है उसके हिसाब से फिर our actions also will depend. For now, we also want that early हमारे जो demands है जल्दी meet हो जाए. हमारे जो जो हमारे जो sister है उसको, जो उनके parents है, उनके family है और colleagues है, उनको जल्दी से जल्दी justice मिल जाए. So that is our demand.
Hello, I am Dr. Tunu Gadi. I am a pediatrician working in Ramakrishna Mission Hospital. And as all of you know and aware of the fact that one of our lady doctors in RJ Kar Medical Hospital has been brutally assaulted, and this is for the entire nation, this is something very unbelievable and unacceptable. Lekin for me as a lady, it is more, I don't have words to express how I am feeling. And I'm sure every woman in this country is also feeling the same feeling. It cannot be expressed in words. Time and again we have seen itna brutality against females, and you would be surprised to know that in India, as of 2024 report, every 6 minutes may one aurat rape hota hai. And if you convert this, it is 100 rapes in a day. This is so astounding. I don't understand what is this. I'm not just talking about the doctors, I'm talking about every female in every workplace, even in their own household. They are not safe. They are not safe in their own home. I'm a pediatrician. I look after children. And the situation is so that when a little baby, a newborn baby comes to me, a female baby, when I look at her, I feel sad. Ki iska kya hone wala hai future mein? You never know who's going to prey her. Predators are lurking. And predators aisa hota hai ki we can't even identify them. They look very normal. So as a female, I'm very sorry. I don't have words. I'm falling short of words to express my anger, my desperation, and I'm tired of pleading to the government why this is not being taken care of. Har samay har jagah ye hota, and the saddest part is that uproars like this will come up, but after some time it will be forgotten. But today we stand with resolve to support the ongoing agitation all over India, so that this is a wake-up call for everyone, for the policy makers. Jis workplace mein, not only hospital, jis workplace mein, safety and security measures are not placed on the top priority list, they should not be allowed to function. Aur ek cheez hai, jo hum Twitter mein dekha tha, there is a certain medical college, jis mein a directive was passed. And it was a gender-based directive, which was shocking. Us directive mein it was written, do's and don'ts only for females. Female doctors ko raat ko udhar nahi jana hai, hospital ke is kona mein nahi jana hai, andhera mein. Jab tum duty mein hai, you are neither a female nor a male doctor, right? We do the same thing. Not just in the hospital, office maybe we do the same work. We earn the same salary. We earn for this nation. Our earning is not gender based. So why directives are gender based? Jab aap night duty mein hota hai aur aapko kahi hospital ka kona hai jisme aapko jana padega, andhera hai, aap nahi bol sakte nahi hum dar lag raha udhar hum nahi jayega, hai na? Patient wahan mein hai, you have to go. Agar nahi jayega, patient will either die, will suffer, and the points will be pointed on the doctor on duty. See, pointing finger ka baat nahi hai. We'll also not feel good. Jab patient bulata hai, dekhne nahi jata hai, to aise nahi hai ki hum log aaram se wahan mein baith ke chinta nahi hota. Hum log ko bahut tension hota hai, are patient ko kya ho raha hoga. So instead of sending such directives, jo work environment hai usko improve karna chahiye. The focus should be on improving the work environment. And there should be a national policy to take care of this. And this is high time that our government should take this very, very seriously. We are women. It doesn't mean that we are vulnerable. It is a society which makes us vulnerable. Our society needs to change their mindset. Otherwise, where will the females go? Female chala gaya toh, the entire world will come to an end. We are the reproducers. We give birth to the children. We give birth to the males. Not only the females. So, it is my earnest request ki crime against and violence against, not only physical violence, not only physical abuse, it is the mental abuse against female. It should come down. Thank you.
जैसे कि बहुत सारा सोशल मीडिया में ऐसे देखने को मिल रहा था कि कलकत्ता में जो ये इंसिडेंट हुआ गया है तो उसमें बहुत सारे लोग आके मूव किया गया है और बहुत सारे एविडेंस को भी हटाने के लिए ट्राई किया है और ऐसे सुनने को मिल रहा था, देखने को भी मिला है सोशल मीडिया में. तो अब बीइंग ए लेडी है तो उन लोगों का गवर्नमेंट को क्या कहना चाहेगा?
यही बोलना चाहेगा कि आई डोंट नो हाउ फार इट इज ट्रू, देयर इज अ डिबेट गोइंग ऑन कि ये जो भी एविडेंस टेम्परिंग है, दिस इज फेक, जो भी न्यूज आ रहा है, आई डोंट नो हाउ फार इट इज ट्रू. इफ इट इज ट्रू देन इट इज वेरी 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 डिसअपॉइंटिंग, क्योंकि दिस इज सच अ हीनस क्राइम, दिस शुड बी टेकन वेरी सीरियसली एंड इट शुड बी टेकन केयर ऑफ एज फास्ट एज पॉसिबल. आई डोंट नो इफ इट वॉज अ मेल डॉक्टर और अ मेल जो भी होता, अगर उसका साथ में ऐसा होता तो ये सब करता क्या? आई डोंट नो. आई एम इन सच ए स्टेट ऑफ माइंड कि अभी ऐसा लग रहा है कि सब एट्रोसिटीज फीमेल का तरफ में ही हो रहा है ना. दिस इज नॉट माई फॉल्ट, दिस इज अ सोसाइटी विच इज मेकिंग मी फील लाइक दिस. आई माइट बी रॉन्ग, आई एम नॉट सेइंग आई एम राइट, बट दिस इज वट इज आवर मेंटेलिटी नाउ. वी आर सो स्केयर्ड नाउ, डर लगता है हम लोगों को कि अभी मेरा साथ में क्या होने वाला है. दिस वॉज नॉट लाइक दिस अर्लियर. अभी आप अंधेरा में जा सकते हैं, लड़की अकेला नहीं जा सकता है ना, रास्ता में नहीं घूम सकता है, लेकिन लड़का तो जा सकता है. व्हाई? दैट इज द क्वेश्चन.